Hello dear students, today let's see how to draw schematic diagram of hyaline cartilage. Before starting drawing this diagram, let's see where this cartilage is located. So it's located in relation with the respiratory tract, where firmness is important. So that is the nasal cartilage, that is the septal cartilage of the nose, then laryngeal cartilage, that is the thyroid, cricoid, and most of the part of arytenoid, tracheal rings, then bronchial cartilages. These are also hyaline cartilage. At the anterior end of the rib, you can see this is the costal cartilage. It is also a variety of hyaline cartilage. Then at the end of the bone, on the epiphysis, the epiphyseal plate of cartilage. So this joint forming surfaces, that is articular surfaces of the bones, these are covered by the articular cartilage, which is also a variety of hyaline cartilage. In fetal life, the fetal skeleton is composed of this hyaline cartilage, which after ossification it forms bone, mature bone. This process is known as enchondral ossification, which takes place in cartilaginous model of the bone. Cartilage tissue is not as rigid as the bone. So this is about the location of hyaline cartilage. Now let's see how to draw H&E diagram of the hyaline cartilage. So very first, with this hematoxylin pencil I am drawing this extracellular matrix of this specialized connective tissue, that is the hyaline cartilage. I am using the hematoxylin pencil forming the basophilic extracellular matrix. This is because of the acidic content of this extracellular matrix, that is chondroitin sulfate and keratin sulfate. These are the ovoid spaces. These are the lacunae. These lacunae, inside it there are cells of the cartilage, that is the chondrocyte. Cells of the cartilage, they are sparsely situated and not compactly or closely situated as like that of the other tissues. Inside the lacunae, these are chondrocytes, nuclei of chondrocyte. Cells are shrunken during the slide preparation, so clear spaces are seen in the lacunae. However, under electron microscope, you will see that these chondrocytes, they are completely filling the lacunae. Under electron microscope, you can see these chondrocytes, they are having a granular cytoplasm because of presence of rough endoplasmic reticulum, which secretes the proteins inside this matrix. As well as it is having the glycogen granules, then lipid droplets, they are also seen. Chondrocytes, they secrete this extracellular matrix, which is rich in the proteoglycans as well as type 2 collagen fibers. However, under light microscope you cannot see or differentiate these collagen fiber, type 2 collagen fibers. This is because the refractive index of the type 2 collagen fiber and the ground substance is same. We will also discuss about the extracellular matrix later on. Now this extracellular matrix, it is, you can see it is somewhat darkly stained around these lacunae. So this is known as territorial matrix. Now start labeling. These are lacuna. Multiple, these are lacunae. Inside this, this is the chondrocyte. This is extracellular matrix, rich in type 2 collagen fibers as well as proteoglycans. Here, this is darkly staining territorial matrix. This is darkly basophilic because of its high acidic content of chondroitin sulfate and keratin sulfate, which is recently secreted by this chondrocyte inside the lacunae. These chondrocytes, they are in a cell nest. So this is, you can see, in a cell nest there may be 2 to 4 chondrocyte cell nest. The acidic component proteoglycan just reduces away from the cell nest. You will see it is somewhat faintly taking the basophilic stain. So this is known as interterritorial matrix. Here this is the perichondrium. Peri, that means around the cartilage. So it is perichondrium. Now this perichondrium, it shows two layers. One, that is the fibrous layer of perichondrium, and below this is the cellular layer, also known as chondrogenic layer. Chondrogenic layer. These are layers of perichondrium. Now this fibrous layer of perichondrium, it contains fibroblast like cells as well as type 1 collagen fibers. It's a dense irregular connective tissue. It shows these capillaries. Label here the capillaries. Few endothelial cells, RBCs. Here this is the cellular layer below the fibrous layer of the perichondrium. It shows some spindle shaped cells like the fibroblast. These are chondroblasts, which are formed from their precursor cells, which are present in the chondrogenic layer. They are converted into these rounded chondroblast. So just below this chondrogenic layer, you will see the mitotic figure in which the cells are in the process of division by mitosis. This darkly staining matrix, this is the capsule. Around it here you can see this territorial matrix, which is having this high concentration of proteoglycans, and in between this is the interterritorial matrix, which is taking lighter stain as compared to territorial matrix. Now here you can see there is no blood vessel inside this cartilage. So it's somewhat avascular structure, and the cartilage cells, it derives its nutrition by diffusion, as the water content of the cartilage is almost 70 to 80%. As a result, the metabolites and nutrients, they are diffused across this cartilage. Now let's see the structure of extracellular matrix. extracellular matrix, it contains these type 2 collagen fibers here, which are fine fibers, and the refractive index of the type 2 collagen fibers and ground substance is same, so we cannot differentiate the fibers under light microscope. And as a result of this similar refractive index of type 2 collagen fiber and the extracellular matrix, it is having a glass like appearance, that is high line appearance. Also, inside this extracellular matrix, you can see there are proteoglycans, which are composed of protein component and glycosaminoglycan component. So proteoglycan, the protein core is present in the center, and around it are sulfated glycosaminoglycans, that is chondroitin sulfate and keratin sulfate. They are attached to this central protein core in a bottle brush configuration, that is in a way of that of the brush which we use to clean the bottle. Proteoglycan molecules, hundreds of these molecules, they are attached to the hyaluronic acid by means of a lean protein, and this forms a hyaluronic proteoglycan agglycan molecule. Agglycan molecules here, they are attached with the type 2 collagen fibers by means of electrostatic forces, and they are forming this three-dimensional network. Proteoglycan, they are having affinity toward water, so they hold water, large amount of water, so they are hygrophilic. As a result, the cartilage, it have around 60 to 80% of water, and the most of the part is of the cartilage is avascular, as simply by diffusion the cartilage cells, that is chondrocyte, they derive their nutrition. Most of the hyaline cartilage, they are having this perichondrium. However, in case of articular cartilage, the perichondrium is absent. So you can see this is a diagram of articular cartilage in which the perichondrium is absent, and this is articular cartilage is present in relation with the joint. So they are on the epiphyseal plate of the bone. So here you can see this surface, which I have stained with a blue mark. This is the synovial facing surface of the articular cartilage, and this is the part of the articular cartilage which is near the bone. Surface of the articular cartilage, it is showing absence of the perichondrium. See, this superficial zone is there, which is showing these elongated cells. Then the middle zone, it shows these cells which are sparsely dispersed. The thickest zone is the middle zone, and in the deep zone you will find the cells are arranged in a vertical rows, a parallel rows, and you can see a tide mark. The tide mark, it separates the cartilaginous part of the bone from the articular cartilage. Now the cartilages, that is hyaline cartilage and articular cartilage, they grow by two types of growth. One, here you can see this is the oppositional growth which is taking place at the periphery. Here the chondrogenic layer, it will be growing as a chondroblast. Chondroblast, they will secrete the matrix and will be entrapped in the lacunae as a chondrocyte. So the layer of the chondroblast is deposited in opposition to the previous layer. So this is the oppositional growth. It increases the width of the cartilage, while the chondrocytes, they will be dividing mitotically and depositing the extracellular matrix. So by this way, this growth is within the substance of the cartilage. So this is interstitial growth of the cartilage. So the cartilage grows by interstitial growth as well as by oppositional growth. आर्टिकुलर कार्टिलेज द थिकनेस इज अराउंड 2 to 4 millimeter. सो दिस इज अबाउट द हायलाइन कार्टिलेज एंड आर्टिकुलर कार्टिलेज. थैंक यू.